If f of x is equal to 2x minus sin x, f from R to R and g of x is equal to x power 1 by 3. F of x is given 2x minus sin x and g of x is given x power 1 by 3. Both the functions are from real numbers to real numbers. Then among the four options here, first option f and g are on to g circle f is 1, 1. Both f and g are 1, 1 and d are at 2. So one thing just you can remember, for 1, 1 function, using your derivatives you can go with, other than the definition of 1, 1 function, which we studied in functions chapter. So you can just make a note here. Either f dash x is greater than 0 or f dash x is less than 0 for all x in the given domain, in the domain of f of x, then we say that f of x is 1, 1. Okay, this is one point you just remember. F dash x greater than 0 or f dash x less than 0 for every x value in the domain of f of x, then we can say f of x is 1, 1. So in this question, f of x is equal to 2x minus sin x, and if I can go with the derivative of it, so 2 minus cos x, and 2 minus cos x is always greater than 0 because cos value lies between, cos x lies between minus 1 to plus 1. So 2 minus cos x is always greater than 0 only, greater than 1 of course, it will be positive. So what is for every value in x? So this is positive for all x belongs to R. Therefore we can say f is 1, 1. Okay, now we'll check for g. G of x is equal to, and g of x is equal to x to the power of 1 by 3. Now we take the derivative of this. G dash x is equal to 1 upon 3, x to the power of 1 by 3 minus 1. That is minus 2 by 3 will get 1 by 3 minus 1, minus 2 by 3. Right? So here also we can say x for any value of x, it is always greater than 0. For any x value belongs to R, g dash x is also positive. So which means that your g of x is also 1 to 1. Okay, g function is also 1, 1. Since f is 1, 1 and g is 1, 1. Since f is 1 to 1 and g is 1 to 1, which implies your g circle f function is also 1 to 1. Or we can write here g is 1, 1 and f is 1, 1. Both are anyhow same. G is 1, 1 and f is 1, 1. So which implies g circle f is also 1 to 1, we can say. So among this, g circle f is 1 to 1. But fourth option is given, all are true. So let's check that part remaining also, whether both onto or not. For onto, for the first function, f of x is equal to 2x minus sin x. For every real number, it is possible. Means you take any value of sin x, 2x minus sin x is always positive. The domain is for real numbers infinity to infinity. Your range also will be infinity to infinity. As x extends to infinity, it also tends to infinity. As x tends to minus infinity, f of x also tends to minus infinity. So we can say clearly f is, we can say that the range of f is minus infinity to infinity as f is continuous. As f is continuous, and hence f of x tends to plus or minus infinity as x tends to plus or minus infinity. Okay, so your range of f of x is minus infinity to infinity, we can consider. And similarly, your g of x function also, what is the domain of the g of x? Is real numbers, any real number. G of x is equal to y. If I take g of x is equal to y, which is equal to x to the power of 1 by 3, so that you will get x is equal to the y to the power of 3. And since y to the power of 3 belongs to minus infinity to infinity, so which also implies that y belongs to minus infinity to infinity. That means your range of g function, range of g of x is minus infinity to infinity. And hence we can say g is onto. And we can also say is f is also onto. Okay, now among the options, both f and g are onto, both f and g are 1-1, and g circle f is 1-1, and hence we can give the answer. Answer can be given D, all are true. Okay.